For most of us, time travel is impossible, but a 25-year-old art director from Portland, Oregon has achieved it in a way. Danielle Delf inserts herself into her mother's old childhood photographs as part of a popular online project she calls If I Had Known My Mother Back Then. And here they are, Danielle and her mother, Janice Thomas. Good morning to both of you.
Hi. Hello.
Start off with, oh, thank you for being here. We'll start off with how this idea came to be, because we've been marveling at these photos all morning long. The edits are seamless. It's almost hard to tell who's who.
Yeah, so I think that at some point we all wonder if we would have been friends with our parents if we'd grown up with them, especially when we get older and we start becoming more friends with them. And I was on Instagram one day, like we all are, and I saw someone post an old high school photo of their mother. It was just an old photo. And I had this moment and I was like, oh my gosh, wouldn't it be so cool if you could take that photo or a photo of my mom from high school and put myself from high school into it and see if we would actually look like we were friends.
I love this idea because we all wonder about connections to our parents, you know, how we're similar, how we're different. You know, sure. We're always looking for similarities. So this whole idea just it sets off so many sparks. Janice, how did you respond when you saw these?
Well, she sent me a link. I get up every morning and look at my phone because she's in Portland. I'm in Pensacola, Florida, and to the website. And I mean, it made me cry. I was like, oh, my gosh. Would have never thought of that concept. I'm not very conceptual, but and it was just, I mean, it literally gave me chills, made me cry. I mean, I kept looking at it all day long, showing it to friends and emailing it, hey, check out what Danielle did. And you know, kind of like, oh, I never got that shout out back in the high school days, but man,
I made up for it.
Hey, this is all right. But I had no idea that it would just take off like this.
I have to ask you, though, because when you look at the photos, they look like perfect matches. Like, if it's her prom, it looks like it was your prom.
Yeah.
Did all the photos exist? Did you have to take fresh ones, or how did you find them?
That's a great question. So I pretty much just went through all of my Facebook photos and tried to have her send me photos. I had family friends send photos. Mm-hmm. I looked for experiences that we were having at the same time and the same age, which was the difficult part.
Yeah.
Because, you know, you're layering expressions and interactions and also the age element on top of it. So that's where it got more complicated, which is why there were 6 images, because out of all the images I had, those were the ones that worked out the best.
What did you see when you put yourselves side by side in the end?
In the end, I really did feel like I saw like 2 girls growing up together, like 2 little lost girls that I had just kind of been able to place together.
Yeah.
So it was kind of this really interesting story of me just digging through both of our pasts and just kind of plopping them together.
Yeah.
And seeing what the interactions looked like.
Now, I think we have a photo that, Janice, you have not seen yet.
That's what I hear.
Let's take a look at it and tell us, I guess, how old you both are in this photo and what we're looking at. Who's who also in this photo?
Wow. Wow. Yeah, that would be, she's got her arm around me. I'm not sure which is left or right. And that is in front of my childhood home, which hopefully when we're in Lexington at Thanksgiving in Kentucky, we'll go back there. But we definitely both had the worst hairdresser doing bangs.
Everybody's my mother, so I'm not sure what that's saying about you.
Well, it's an absolutely fantastic project. Really cool. Danielle Delf, Janice Thomas, thank you so much for being here and sharing your photographs with us.
Thank you.